Welcome back to Living 808. We're in for a real treat today. I hope you all grab that paper at home, maybe some origami paper or any kind of paper.
Any
just
paper.
To try to try. Yeah? Mm-hmm. Because Alexis will be teaching us how to make Precious Moments origami box. Alexis, tell a little bit about the box and what we're going to be doing today.
Of course. So as a contestant, I had the opportunity to take origami class from one of our instructors, Mrs. Yajima. Mm-hmm. And she taught us how to make one of these boxes, actually. It's a 16 pieces origami.
That's but I very
thought
complex.
Maybe this might be a little too difficult for today, so okay. I wanted to teach you how to do a little easier origami precious memory box. And you can use calendar paper, you can use programs from, you know, recitals, even wallpaper. This is from Mrs. Yajima's kitchen. She wanted me to share that with you. But any loose papers, just recycle and reuse.
All right. Anything that's, does it have to be harder cardstock or just anything?
No,
anything that's
anything.
Foldable, right?
Yeah. You know, this is a card that my aunt gave me. From the festival ball, and it's okay. just you can even use a greeting card.
All right, this is Mrs. Yajima. Apparently, she is the most well-respected member of the Cherry Blossom organization because she's been there from the start.
Yeah, she actually helped recruit the first 72 women in the first Cherry Blossom Festival.
Oh, she really gives back.
Years ago. Yeah, and this is the 64th festival, so we're still going, and she's been such a great influence.
Well, Mrs. Yajima, this is for you. I'm going to try my best. But okay, how do we do this?
Okay,
now?
So I helped do some folding for you. So what we're going to do first is I'll just have you fold each corner to the center.
Okay. Each corner to the
these
center.
These papers are 5.5 by 5.5 inches, so it's really simple. And after this step, all you're going to do is from this corner, fold it in halfway.
Like that?
Yep, perfect.
Okay.
And fold that in. Yep, halfway. And then open it up one more time. And now you're going to do the same fold, but going the other way.
Okay, with everything in there, right?
Yep, uh-huh.
Thank you for pre-folding this for me.
No problem. First grade teacher.
Okay. Always
so I'll help you with this part. So if you can see, the flap's kind of open already.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to open it like this. And I made these lines just in case you're wondering how we cut this at home. I'm going to go ahead and trade out the paper. So after you cut along the lines, it'll kind of look like this. Okay?
She pre-cut the paper.
I did. I
That's
pre-cut it for you.
That's how much faith she had in me. She pre-cut the paper, put a target right in the middle.
That's the center.
Okay, and what do we do with that?
Okay, so if you can just open the glue, and we're just going to do a little glue right on top of the X. Because this is how we hold the box together. The paper that we're using is actually a program from the Honolulu Festival this past year.
Okay.
Okay, so that's
Did
good.
I do it okay there, Mrs. Okihara?
Yes, it looks good. Okay, so I'll help you with this part. We're going to actually fold it in like this, right, so the corners go to the center.
Okay.
And what you do with the flaps, they automatically fold in. We're going to bring it over here, lift this corner up. Put it down. And the
Let me do the other side. Let me do the other side.
Okay, I might need to put more glue for you, actually.
Oh, okay.
Okay, there you go. Now you try the other side.
All right, so this goes up like...
Oh, other side first.
Okay, right here?
Yes.
All right, like this, and then goes inside. Wait.
Almost.
Wait, hold up. Let's see.
Do you feel how it's already pulling?
Yeah, it doesn't feel...
Do you need help?
Yeah, wait, hold on. Give me a chance.
Okay.
Oh, okay, wait. Like this?
Yeah, and then... Pull this down to make the side. Yes.
Okay.
Perfect. Mm-hmm. Yay! Good job!
Wow! Expert status. Okay, so this is the, the top?
Yes, and I actually made the bottom for you. So just for the bottom, you usually go a quarter of an inch in the dimensions, smaller. So you can put the box perfectly like this. And it's a really beautiful design. And so Mrs. Yajima told me you can use any material you have at home, programs, calendars, wallpapers, anything you have to, you know, just be eco-friendly and reuse things at home. She wanted me to show this. This is from her granddaughter's recital.
Mm.
And her, if you want to make a keepsake box, you can actually cut, you know, your granddaughter's name or cousin's name or whatever. And that's actually her granddaughter's name right inside the box. So when she uses it, she remembers what this program was from.
That is fantastic because each box is a very special moment, potential or emotional. Okay, and she made numerous boxes for the KHON2 staff.
Yes, I have a box for everyone to share. It's such an easy thing to do. It's so fun, and you know, I use this at work, organize my paper clips, my rubber bands. My kids love it.
And so you could put the glue inside this box. Fits right there.
Yes, exactly.
Well, we want to thank you. Thank you for showing me how to do this. I've never made anything outside of a paper plane. and Miss Yajima, thank you for your service. to the Cherry Blossom Festival and all of the origamis that she made for our staff here today. Good fun. I don't know if I can do it again, but, you know,
I hopefully think you can.
Maybe we'll post it online and maybe I could practice. But coming up.